History is about to take place as we get ready for the first time ever, a one-on-one Shiners Showdown. Okay, it's time for the Maggie Valley Feud Face-Off. Judges, you will take a sip of each of the shines that are going head-to-head and then secretly vote for which one you like better. Your vote will be put into these marked envelopes at the end. We will tally the votes and declare a winner. All right, let's start with category number one, fruit-based shine. Judges, grab the glass marked 1A and take a sip.
Don't taste much fruit.
I think it's citrus.
You know, it's pleasant. It's a pleasant drink.
But Digger, you said you picked up on a citrus.
I pick up a citrus note on it, and it's a little bitter, which is, you know, a common thing that happens with citrus.
That's a good
fruit. But it's a good dry finish.
I mean,
good
it would finish. Hold up. It would hold up well in a cocktail.
Let's go to 1B. Tell me what you guys think. This is the fruit category. Mike and Richard head to head.
I can't determine what kind of fruit it is.
Y'all sure that's fruit? I'm
it's
tasting
fruit.
Chocolate.
I get a good sweet finish to it.
I'm picking up chocolate.
We always say on Master Distiller, proof is important, but at the end of the day, it still comes down to flavor.
For the fruit category, you guys pick your 1A or 1B.
I'm done.
All right, I'm putting your answers into this envelope. All right, the votes are in the envelope. But first, let's find out who's 1A and who's 1B. Mike, you are 1A. Can you tell us what you brought in the fruit category?
It's Satsuma from Mississippi down south. They only, you know, pretty much grow in that region. They can't survive up here. And I actually peeled each and every one of those that used no pith whatsoever that could be helped into the whole batch.
And these are from your grandfather's farm?
From my grandfather's farm.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, Richard, you are 1B. What did you bring us?
That's a pawpaw brandy.
What exactly is a pawpaw brandy?
A hillbilly mango is what I heard.
Okay.
So it's a cross between.
Wonder where you got that from.
Around the corner from your house.
Sure did, didn't you?
All right, come on. I put you guys at the end of the table. I don't want to have to separate you.
It's multiple tastes. I mean, some people say it's a cross between a mango and a banana. I mean, he picked up cherry in it. He picked up chocolate in it. They're really good.
Okay, let's move on to our next category. This is going to be corn liquor, 2C and 2D. So let's start.
I mean, it's got color to it. So, I mean, did they age it or something? I put it in some wood? I put wood in it or something?
Got a little oakiness to it.
Yeah, it's got a little age on it. It's been chipped or...
Doesn't have any fire on the back end.
Let's move on to 2D.
All right, 2D.
What are you guys getting?
That one's down in the tails pretty good. I can see oils on top of the...
There's a lot of flavor to it.
Interesting.
It's not that clear.
Okay, you guys ready to vote on the corn liquor category? Okay, I got Tim's vote.
That one's easy.
All right, I got the votes in for the corn category. 2C, Richard, right?
Yes.
What did you bring?
My long game.
Your long game?
Yeah, that's for later on. That's just some good corn liquor right there. And I toasted some oak to put that in. So that oak that you're tasting is out the backyard.
So you put the oak in it?
Yes.
Okay. Mike, you were 2D. What did you bring us?
2D. Yeah, it's just a simple white corn recipe that I've made for years. Family recipe that's been lent down from Mississippi and all.
Good flavor. It's a good drink.
It reminds me of making it with fresh corn.
Really? It was made with ground white corn.
Mm.
All right, let's move on to the third category, flavored shine. So let's start 3E.
I never tasted anything like that before.
It don't have any boundaries, really, the flavored shine.
It doesn't have boundaries, that's right.
It's a tiny bit harsh on the aftertaste.
Let's move on to 3F.
It's like a chocolate malt with alcohol in it.
I'm a tasting pecan. Pecan, maybe a butter pecan.
Is it pecan or pecan?
Either or.
Well, depends on your circumstances. If you're wanting a pie, it's pecan. If you need a pea, it's pecan.
And I'm going to, if I was just guessing, I'm saying it's maybe on the upside 50 proof.
50 proof?
Yeah, it's being generous, I think.
Less.
Yeah.
And I may be completely off.
Maybe 40.
Game. Maybe, you know, but it's.
All right, so in this category, we have two shines. In the flavored shine category.
Well, you know, I like high proof liquor. We've got one of those on the table. And I like sipping creams because they're good. I mean, you can drink on them all day long and then, you know, finally end up being drunk later on that night.
Let's pick your favorite in the flavored shine category. And I'm putting them into this envelope. Richard, you were 3E. What did you bring?
I said apple rye. And I didn't flavor it at all. It came out of the still like that. That's the flavor of this alcohol straight from the worm right there. I didn't need to do anything else to it.
Okay. So Mike, you were 3F.
3F, yep.
What is that?
That is obviously a post-flavored alcohol, butter pecan. Y'all was right, y'all picked up those flavors.
Yep.
The customers that I sell to, they love post-flavored sipping creams, stuff like that. So I make what sells the most, it makes me the most money.
Sure. All right, guys, the votes are in. Okay, what do you say? Let's reveal the winner of each category, and the person who wins the most categories wins the showdown. All right, the first category was fruit-based shine. The winner of that category is in this envelope. Mike brought a Satsuma shine. Tim said he wanted more fruit. Mark said it was pleasant. Digger said he can taste the citrus. Richard brought a pawpaw shine to the table. Tim said, I taste chocolate. Mark, I can't determine what kind of fruit this is. Digger, it's quite nice. The winner of this category, fruit-based shine, it was a 2-1 vote. And the winner is Mike. Mike won the first flavored shine category. That's one for Mike. Next category, corn liquor. Richard brought a toasted oat corn liquor. Tim said, tasting wood flavor. Mark, there's fire at the back end. Digger said, I appreciate it. Mike brought a family corn recipe. Tim said, it's smooth but cloudy. Mark said, lots of flavor. Digger said, this liquor was in the tails. The winner of the corn liquor category in a 3-0 vote, Richard. That's one category for Mike and one category for Richard. And I'm about to throw up. I mean, let's be honest, come on. You guys have gotta be sweating it out. This last category determines who wins the Shiner Showdown of Maggie Valley. Flavored shine. Richard, he brought an apple rye. Tim said, never tasted anything like this before. Mark said, it has no boundaries. Digger, I can't tell the flavor. Mike brought a butter pecan. Tim, sweet like ice cream. Mark said, a drink like this is very popular. And Digger said, I could drink this all day. A 2-1 vote. For all the marbles, here we go. The winner is Mike.
Hey, Mike? Kim apples.
Hey, man, I never said you don't make good liquor. You just need to make better liquor in Maggie Valley.
Hey, who's the winner of down Maggie Valley?
Mike, congratulations.
Proof's in alcohol, man. You know, now that all that's said and done, this whole feud thing, I'd like to say it wasn't personal, but we all know it really is. And hey, you know, the proof is on the table now.
Not according to your customers.
Oh, well.
You can't sell liquor to just these
that.
Three.
You still leave in Maggie Valley, so let's
don't
even go there.
I ain't going nowhere, man.
Okay, all right. Well, there seems to be a lot of unfinished business between Mike and Richard, and you're gonna have to tune in to find out what happens.